Curly lived the shortest life of the Stooges, dying at the age of 48. He was given a Jewish funeral and laid to rest at the Western Jewish Institute section of Peace Cemetery in East Los Angeles. Curly's older brothers, Benjamin and Shem, and parents, Jenny, Solomon, are all interred there as well. Here's a little bit about Curly's personal life. Believe it or not, Curly's off-screen personality was the opposite of his on-screen manic persona. He was an introvert. He generally kept to himself, rarely socializing with people unless he had been drinking, which he would increasingly turn to as the stresses of his career grew. In addition, he came to life when the presence of Brother Shemp would be around, and Curly could not be himself around Brother Mo, who treated his younger brother with a fatherly wag of the finger. That kind of fit Mo's personality. Curly was never an intellectual, didn't graduate high school. Curly simply refrained from engaging in crazy antics unless he was in his element, with family, performing, or intoxicated. Curly was insecure about his shaved head. He believed it made him unappealing to women. He increasingly drank to excess and caroused to cope with his feelings of inferiority. He took to wearing a hat in public to convey an image of masculinity, saying he felt like a little kid with his hair shaved off, even though he was popular with women all his life. In fact, many who knew him said women were his main weakness. Mo's son-in-law, Norman Maurer, even went so far as to say he was a pushover for women. If a pretty girl went up to him and gave him a spiel, Curly would marry them. Then she would take all his money and run off. It was the same when a real estate agent would come up and say, "I have a house for you, Curly. Would you sell his current home and buy another one?" During World War II, for 7 months of each year, the Three Stooges' filming career would go on hiatus, and that would allow them to make personal appearances for the troops. The Stooges entertained servicemen constantly, and the intense work schedule took its toll on Curly. He never drank while performing on stage. Mo would not allow it. But once away from Mo's watchful eye, he would find the nearest nightclub, down a few drinks, and enjoy himself. His drinking, eating, and carousing increased. He had difficulties managing his finances, often spending his money on wine, food, women, homes, cars, especially dogs, and was often near poverty. Mo eventually helped him manage his money and even filled out his income tax returns. Curly found constant companionship in his dogs and often befriended strays whenever the Stooges were traveling. There was an episode where there were a lot of dogs involved, and I remember Curly looked very comfortable around them. He would pick up homeless dogs and take them with him from town to town until he found them a home somewhere else on the tour. When not performing, he would usually have a few dogs waiting for him at his home. Mo urged Curly to find himself a wife, hoping it would persuade his brother to finally settle down and allow his health to improve somewhat. After a two-week courtship, he married a woman by the name of Marion Buxbaum, October 17, 1945, and that marriage lasted approximately 3 months. The divorce proceeding was a bitter one. Of course, it was exploited by the local media. After the divorce, his health fell into rapid and devastating decline. Curly's legacy? He is considered by many fans and critics alike to be their favorite member of the Three Stooges. In a 1972 interview, Larry Fine recalled, "Personally, I thought Curly was the greatest because he was a natural comedian who had no formal training. Whatever he did, he made up on the spur of the moment. When we lost Curly, we took a hit. Curly's mannerisms, behavior, and personality, along with his catchphrases of yuck, 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 woo, 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 and certainly have become a part of American popular culture. Steve Allen, a famous comedian and talk show host, called him one of the most original yet seldom recognized comic geniuses. I could not agree with him more. Few comics have come close to equaling the pure energy and genuine sense of fun Curly was able to project. He was merriment personified, a creature of frantic action whose only concern was to satisfy his immediate cravings, allowing his emotions to dominate and making no attempt whatsoever to hide his true feelings. He would chuckle self-indulgently at his own cleverness. When confronted with the problem, he would grunt, slap his face, and tackle the obstacle with all the tenacity of a six-year-old child. On several occasions, Mo was convinced that rising star Lou Costello, who was a close friend of Shemp, was stealing material from Curly. Costello was known to acquire prints of the Stooges films from Columbia Pictures on occasion, presumably to study Curly. Inevitably, Curly's routines would show up in Abbott and Costello feature films, much to Moe's chagrin. Another unfortunate thing was that the Columbia Pictures president, Harry Cohn, would not allow the Stooges to make feature-length films like their contemporaries, Laurel and Hardy, the Marx Brothers, and Abbott and Costello. I could only imagine how phenomenal a full-length Stooges film would have been made in the era when the Three Stooges were at their best with Mo, Larry, and Curly. I could hear Curly's remark to that particular situation with one of his famous phrases, "I'm a victim of circumstance." Yep, he had all the phrases, and we have all the memories. And thank you, the Three Stooges, especially to my favorite, Curly Howard. Curly Howard was born Jerome Lester Horwitz, October 22nd, 1903, and he passed away January 18, 1952. And as most people know, he is better known by his stage name, Curly Howard. He was, of course, an American comedian and a vaudevillian actor. He was best known as a member of what is called the American farce comedy team, the Three Stooges, of course. Also featured his older brothers, Mo and Shemp Howard, and Larry Fine. Curly was generally considered the most popular and recognizable of the Three Stooges. He was well known for his high-pitched voice and vocal expressions such as nyuk, 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 woo, 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 and certainly, and barking like a dog, as well as his physical comedy, falling on the ground, pivoting on his shoulder, spinning. Actually, he could have been considered the first breakdancer. He would walk in circular motions, do improvisations, all kinds of interesting and funny slapstick type comedy. He actually was an untrained actor. Curly was born in Brooklyn, the Bensonhurst section of Brooklyn, that is a borough of New York City, was of Lithuanian Jewish ancestry. He was the youngest of five sons, and because he was the youngest, his brothers called him Babe to tease him. That name stuck with him throughout his entire life. Although when his brother Shemp Howard married, he was also nicknamed Babe. The brothers called him Curly to avoid the confusion, and that is how Curly got the nickname Curly. Curly was a quiet child, rarely caused any problems for his parents, unlike his older brothers, Mo and Shem. They were said to excel in causing problems for the parents. He was a mediocre student, but did well as an athlete on the school basketball team. He never graduated from high school. He kept himself busy with odd jobs and constantly following his older brothers, whom he idolized. He was also, believe it or not, an accomplished ballroom dancer and singer. And he regularly turned up at what was known as the Triangle Ballroom in Brooklyn, occasionally bumping into George Raft, the famous actor who was known to play gangsters and that sort of thing. When Curly was 12, he accidentally shot himself in the left ankle while cleaning a rifle. Mo rushed him to the hospital and saved his life. The wound resulted in a noticeably thinner left leg and a slight limp. I wonder if that had anything to do with some of his gyrations and motions when he was doing his comedy. He was so frightened of surgery that he never had the limp corrected. Can't blame him. While with the Stooges, he developed his famous exaggerated walk to mask the limp on the screen. Curly was interested in music and comedy and would watch his brothers Shrimp and Mo perform as Stooges in Ted Healy's vaudeville act. Ted Healy was actually the founder and formed the very original Three Stooges. Ted Healy used to play along with the Three Stooges. He was kind of like the fourth Stooge or the straight man. He also liked to hang around backstage, although he never participated in any of the routines. So that answers the question about Curly being in any of these Ted Healy routines. Curly married his first wife, Julia Rosenthal, on August 5th, 1930, but the couple had their marriage annulled shortly afterwards. Curly's first onstage break was a comedy musical conductor in 1928 for the Orville Knapp Band. Mo later recalled that his performances usually overshadowed those of the band. Though Curly enjoyed the gig, the work, he watched his older brothers Mo and Shemp and partner Larry Fine made it big as some of Ted Healy's Stooges. Vaudeville star Healy had a popular stage act in which he would try to tell jokes or sing only to have the Stooges wander on the stage and interrupt or heckle him and cause disturbances from the audience. Meanwhile, Healy and company appeared in their first feature film, Rube Goldberg's Soup to Nuts, in 1930. Shemp, however, disliked Healy. He disliked Healy's bad temper, heavy drinking. So, in 1932, he was offered a contract with a movie studio in Brooklyn. And he took that contract. And when that happened, that is when Curly became part of the Three Stooges act.